Sapa O'Chau bottle, and we ask our tour guide to fill the water, so not always bring the plastic bottle or something, so not infected. So from that, this little action, and we hope that people around during their trip or around them see that why we have doing that, right? And why we just did use the plastic bottle, right? So the education step by this. It's still a lot of challenging, but we hope one day will be slowly changing bit by bit, yeah.
Yeah, thank you. And I think Sapa O'Chau is like leading by example, first teaching children and students to protect the environment, and later on they can make bigger impact to the community. Yeah, so the next question I want to ask you is about like the 17th goal of in 7 SDG is partnership with other organization to implement the goal. So how does Sapa O'Chau partner with other international organizations or NGO to develop your social enterprise?
To do a social work is not easy. Yeah, it's not easy. To do the same time as your business woman, as your business person, and you are a social person, it's not an easy way. But I know that's not easy, that's why I had to do it, and I do it. It's easy, everybody already do it, right? So we had a lot of partners from around the world, but what we are doing is that we working with CC. CC is one of our social enterprise, local NGO in Hanoi, and they support the social enterprise Vietnam. And we also doing some tourism work with them, or we continue to do a certain project in our hometown. And we also partner with them, and we also partner with KOTO, that we know some of our students that want, for example, our student finish high school and they want to go have better career, like be a cook, chef, or they want to be a bartender or other, so in a hospitality with. And if there are case that they are background or family or the passion they want to go, and once they go in the future, then according to the selection from the KOTO, that we also partner with them, the same some student that learn from KOTO, there's some partner that we are doing. And our partnership also that we have some partner travel agency that from the business that they also send a client to us, that way we can get financial and to support the community what we are doing. So, but more now that we feel that in technology is very good, that for example, our partners that are, be a partner, we don't have much a partner, but we normally contact the client direct through the internet, like they knowing us through the internet, like touring the book, like Lonely Planet, or the searching in Google, or yeah, in our website, so coming from Facebook, you know. So we want, like before when I was starting checking our company, many travel agency that know my don't believe you because you come from background of the community and they don't believe much about your skills. So for us, we want the I want to find the solution that direct to the client. And because many people now they travel with smaller group, not a big group, so they are searching or they are traveling. So we don't have partner, but this was so that our client and our guests that we're looking for. And but in the long term or the product, we also try to work with the partner, travel agency, local NGO, and other university that we try to partner with them and send our student over there study or sending our staff to there to study some knowledge that they can better invest directly to their community, because they are the one who understand well who they are and what field they are. So if they have the best knowledge, they can obey, they can able to share between different language like their Hmong or their Zhao or their other minority, they also share, and they can, because they grow from there, you know, so they can feel really inside. Not just you are bleeding inside, you just put the band-aid on and you say, oh, that's okay. But you know, people need now is kind of passion or developed inside their field, you know. If they want to do, they will do it, you know. If you, they don't want to learn, you how many tell, how many you ask them to do, they will not do it. But if they really want to do it, they want to achieve their dream, they want to be over there. Anyhow, there was sort of way to go there, you know. So that's how we are providing the partner and try to work with other. And we openly were looking for many different partnerships around the world. Yes.
Well, yeah, so as we can see that the impact of one individual is not enough to make a change, right? And although the impact of a social enterprise is bigger, but still, maybe it will like more beneficial if you will have the benefit between different organizations so that we can make bigger impact. And I think that when you come here, it's also like part of the partnership between Sapa O'Chau and AYSD as well, so that Ms. Shu can give you more sharing, more insight about sustainable tourism, so that we can learn from your lesson and make bigger impact. The next question I want to share with, I want to ask you is about children. So, you know, when we go to Sapa, a lot of tourists give candies to children, and they also give money or candy to begging children. And one of the travel tips provided by UNWTO is that tourists should not give money or candy to the children. So can you share with us the reason why?
Yes, so for the people who are traveling, is that they always feel that, okay, we see the local people or the children are so poor and we want to give some money, or maybe they need some sweet, they don't have it, you know? And everybody want to give straight away and they feel good in the moment. But in the long term or in the thing that moment is not helping the community or not helping the children grow. If you are giving, for example, if you are giving the children money or candy, for candy it will be very fixed, the children, like a lot of it come from the children, because you know that in the community they don't have the daily life. Like when you are grow, your parents say, oh, you brush teeth or you have to wash your hand before you eat, but the community, they are living like more natural and they don't have this that they do not have this practice for many, like winter in the mountain. So this will come to the community, but need to stand slowly. And the parents do not have much knowledge how with hygiene, you know? Yeah, so if you give too much candy for the children, they don't know how to brush their teeth, so they have a lot of decay, you know, and that is effect. The tourists or people who come along, maybe they might say, oh, well, the children need sweet or we give them. But, you know, actually in the back, there will be effect that a lot. But most people don't think this yet. They normally just at the moment, oh, they need we give, you know. And that's because if the tourists come and one person do that, the next person, the children say, oh, I need candy, you know. And they always, if you don't give them, they also might be aggressive to you or angry you. Why did you not give me a candy, right? Or, you know, or maybe trying to see other people having, you know, kind of a lot of things going on. And besides, if you give money to the children, you know, it's not good because the children feel that my money is so easy. And, you know, and this group come in and give them money, but the not so group, they come, they ask. And that will be like a practice. And because before they never doing that, they're very poor and they're very nice. But because if coming to the community and sometimes people action like that, even you see in tourist district, we have a lot of children asking for money or asking for, you know. I see that a lot of some other children say, can you give me money please, you know, for example. So for us a person, our adult or anybody who will travel out, I think they should be responsible with their action. Yeah, even like give, because that's what my work might be happy, you know? But it might be happy to give like $1 or $2, but in the long term, the children, you know, we were train the children to be a person that, well, they will think my money is so easy, you know? For example, in our play that now we have no many, but only few, but the children, they don't used to do that all, but belong their parents going to selling thing, or they don't have people to look at the baby children that they walk along, and when they walk along, they're selling handicraft or thing. And the tourists, they also, the baby is so poor, right? They try to give some money to the baby. And from that, they can see from that, just this habit, right? From tourists, this habit from the tourists. And the parent, the